this is an offer, but we can move the plot along a lot faster if you quit interrupting me. Sit tight, and you'll get your big opening number in a moment. As I was saying, once upon a time, in Alcantara, Spain, lived a queen and her only child, the Princess Altamira. The queen thought Altamira to be the most pleasingly beautiful creature to ever grace the face of this earth, and reminded her every day just how lovely and pretty she was. Naturally, the courtiers, the court poet, the servants, the knights, and all the common folk followed suit. So, the princess was led to believe herself to be the fairest maiden in Alcantara and beyond! Unfortunately, however, the princess was, well, how does one put this tactfully? She was not quite as attractive as everyone pretended, particularly when one takes into consideration the standards of beauty of the times. Hairy warts, bad teeth were not the style. And, okay, if we're being completely honest, the princess was ugly by any standard. In fact, she was so ugly that when she rode through the streets of Alcantara, the children ran away, thinking she was a witch! I'm exaggerating, of course. The children were really quite fond of her, but she was very patient and kind with them. But you get my point. She was ugly. She was, in fact, so very ugly that she could make an onion cry, or so the saying goes.
Thank you. tell where you flip a coin for her?
Look back. I have high hopes for him. I just sense that today will be the day I meet my future. I can feel it. I know I'm looking my best in my favorite dress. I just hope he doesn't swoon too much while basking in my pulchritude. So many of the others seem to have difficulty making eye contact with me, since I radiate so much gloriousness. It is my curse and my cross to bear to be so uncorruptedly and impeccably gorgeous. Oh, never mind. I refuse to be gloomy and bemoan my beauty. Let us go off to greet him.
I must have just missed my lovely Altamira. Joy of my heart, apple of my eye, light of my life. Has there ever been a more beautiful child? She's my Aphrodite, my Iris, my Athena, my sun, moon, and stars. She was such a sweet baby.
Today is the first day of my future. I hear the princess is a vision of loveliness. I am quite pleased that she will be easy on the eyes.
I believe, Your Highness, we were told she was a vision. The messenger is slightly and puzzlingly uncomfortable in his delivery.
Whatever the case, her looks... her looks hardly signify. I need money, and I need it now. Oh, I'm tired of pretending to have funds I don't and feeling poor. Oh, look at my fringe cuffs, oh, and my scuffed shoes. Oh, it's a disgrace. I look like a beggar, and I hate beggars. Wretched creatures always wanting something. Just to pay for food, Your Highness! Just to pay for my serving children, Your Highness! Bah! As if I would care about their little problems. Alcantara has some of the richest lands in Spain, being Princess Altamira's prince, and the future king. We'll secure funds to create my dreams. They are big dreams. The biggest dreams, believe me, no one has bigger dreams than I.
Yes, you told me, as a prince, you want to build a fence.
No. I have always wanted to build a wall. Should be the tallest and the biggest wall of all. Nothing small to keep out the riffraff, the beggars and the poor, who always have their hands out and always ask for more. It's such a bore, I just ignore and shut. Dame panni di me, tanto quanto I want I get it, from the pile of us of everyone. Cross me once and you are done. Let me tell a little story of my native Terry. Tory, all the people pay a tax.
Source for the income.
Oh.
They can't even farm there. All of the rich land is within the limits.
What do I care? It's
on my problem once they are ousted. I'm being magnanimous by sparing their lives. The remaining denizens of Alcantara will thank me for ridding them of the pestilent poor. Let's hurry. If I play my cards right, I can accurately blame the state of my shoes and cuffs on an innocent street urchin, and perhaps procure a new outfit. I wonder if they still use torture for punishment in Alcantara.
I believe that it has been outlawed for over 100 years.
Well, then that will be my first order of business then. That and my precious wall. Oh, this thing is getting better and better by the minute.
Traversing the road without the gift of sight is difficult. I am weary of travel. I hear that Princess Altamira is the epitome of kindness itself. I also hear that her musical taste is not overly discerning. I hope to dazzle her with my slightly limited repertoire and somewhat mediocre fiddle playing. I am certain I could be of some use to this community if I just have a little time and security. I know I can hone my skills and expand my slightly limited repertoire.
Things are bad out here.
overly optimistic princess.
Although, I'm not entirely certain it isn't celery. Oh, come on, Mr. Poet, let's get married.
I'm already married.
Well, that is a problem. I do not imagine your current wife would take kindly to you having another. Mm. Yes, see how you tremble? She must be quite a commanding woman to incur so much fear.
Oh, yes, she is very commanding and demanding. I would never dare cross her.
Oh, very interesting. Why is it that we have never met, much less seen your illicit bride?
Well, truth be told is, she is very shy.
I thought she was commanding and demanding.
Oh, yes, she is all that in a very unobtrusive way.
Enough! Off with his head!
Oh, mother, do settle down. Ah! I put that ass down!
Oh, yes. Please do so, Your Highness. If something were to happen to me, we'll never find out how the story ends.
I propose that four knights shall be chosen, and that these should fight for the hand of the lovely Altamira. The survivor will be rewarded by marrying her.
Well, that is an excellent idea.
You, and you. Step forward for a joust.
Up, two, three, four.
It's a real blood bath out there!
What a mess!
and night is eternal. Thither will I go, for in the dark, as all cats are gray, so are all degrees of beauty brought to one common level. I now know that it is just as unfortunate to be too beautiful as it is to be very ugly.
Princess, to Spain, nothing is denied. My name is Feliberto. You speak of proceeding to the north, where the day never dawns in search of a husband. You need but look at me to behold one to whom night and day, extreme ugliness and transcendent beauty are alike. As since they all are so bashful that they will not marry you, allow me, fair princess, to offer you my services as a husband. In my world, handsome is as handsome does, and your most important attribute to me is not your unparalleled facade, but rather your legendary kindness of heart. I know not how I appear to you, so I may be well out of my league for asking, but I would consider myself very fortunate if you would entertain my suit. Will you come near so that I may see you with my hand? What an interesting combination of texture. Princess, I can tell you are a fascinating creature. Lovely. You have very nice hair. My, oh my. What a meaty pumpkin. You are full of great strength and independence. We will have fine, strapping children. What a pretty speech from an even prettier man. Isn't he scrumptious, Mother? I should very much like to meet him.
Indeed, he is a fine gentleman, with handsome words. He has expressed his worthiness eloquently. I approve of this marriage!
Yes!
But first, I have something to reveal. Come with me for a moment, dear.
So
must be more than one of those hideous concoctions. But how is this vision of beauty able to fit in it? And why would you want to?
Are you and the princess, relatives?
Sort of.
Eureka! Of course you are! How stupid of me! You must be her beautiful cousin. Are you more closely related?
Maybe.
You are her sister, then! Nobody told me there was a sister, but it all makes sense! Pawn off the ugly one first in hopes that somebody will take her and keep the pretty one hidden away.
Well, dear other much improved princess, you're coming with me,
and we shall get married post haste.
No! You don't understand! You are not a nice man at all! I will not marry you!
Don't be ridiculous! Of course you will! I always get what I want. Lucky for you, I want you! Let's go find the priest!
No! Get your hands off me, Alcantara!
Self-sufficient and battle-worthy. So, you might be surprised to hear that my impaired vision is problematic when wielding a weapon. To have a girl who is strong enough to bear arms for both of us is an irreplaceable asset.
I hadn't thought of it that way, but you are correct. You're a lover and not a fighter. These hands were made to hold a violin, not a sword. I am strong, like you said, and I know how to fight rather well. Although, I would only hurt truly bad people. Oh, Bertie, my love and my rock, you who have stood steadfast by me through thick and through thin, through sickness and, well, some dramatic physical changes, and health for the past 15 or so very tumultuous minutes. Let us be married and pledge our troth from here to eternity. Woo!
to sadness and keep an open door.
By working all together, we'll be better than before. We'll restore our rough home. Heretofore, take care of our home.
And is this part of the family? Is this part of the family?
Got the print.